I love this self-centering, not so expensive doweling jig, and it's got holes of different sizes, but I almost always use it with these holes here, so I really wish it had these sleeves on this side too, so I could position four holes accurately. But sometimes I want to drill holes off-center, or I might want to drill holes in a face, something like this, and for cases like that, I end up picking the jig apart and just clamping one side. And I have to put a shim between the one side I keep and that. And now I can use it to drill holes offset from one side of a wide workpiece. But for this application, I think it would be easier just to have this bar with four holes in it, and I can just jig the rest of it up with pieces of wood. So I bought this chunk of steel from a local scrapper, and it's about the right dimensions thickness and width-wise if I cut it off here. And I'll try to do that with an angle grinder. I actually adjusted the guard on this and this spacer here to keep that blade exactly level, and so if I just run along this block, I should be able to make that cut fairly accurately. Now that it's cooled down a bit, I can handle it better, and that cut, it feels just silky smooth. And you can see the reflection in it quite well too. And it's square enough for my needs. That looks so much better now that I got the mill scale ground off of it. Got my workpiece clamped in here, and I've already verified that it's square enough. And I don't have an edge finder, so I just have an 8mm shaft in here. And if I just touch that to the edge here, that gives me a reference there. And I worked out the geometry, so I know I need to move that from where it is right now, 11.8mm, to get in the center across from here. So I got a dowel indicator on here, and let's just make sure that's zeroed. So I need to bring it out 11.8mm this way. Okay, so I'll just count the turns. 1, 2, 3, and 11.8. So I need to be right about here. And I just lock that in by doing up this little screw down here with a wrench. Now for my lateral position, the dial indicator won't reach, so I'm going to just touch off the end here. And I have to keep the same direction, so that's touching now. And now I need to move 13.825mm, 4mm per turn. So I just got my finger on where the one was here, and I go 1, 2, 3, so that's 12mm plus another millimeter plus 0.825, and that lines up with the marks I made on here that I scratched in with the calipers, so I'll lock this position here, and now I can switch to a short drill in here, and this just happens to be an 8mm drill, so I can keep the same collet in the chuck. And I switched a pulley to go for the lowest speed that I can get, so now I can start the first hole here. So I'm just using that 8mm drill bit as a center drill to basically form that divot, because the next drill is just going to follow that position. Now I need to move 19.05mm over this way. And I'll put my finger on here, and so that's 4 turns and 3mm. 1, 2, 3, and 0.05. Oh, I missed one. Ah! And I screwed up and I lost my reference. So I'm just going to go back to this pin here to get a reference. So now I just touched off of here again, and I need to move 32.875mm. So that's 8 turns. 1, 2, 7, 8, and then 0.875mm, and that lines up with the mark I made, so I think that should be good. I'll just lock that in real good, and I think I'm ready to place the next hole. I'm stirring this very gently because that drill's got a bit of wobble, and if I start it hard, it might be off by the wobble. And almost 3 millimeters. 1, 2, 3. And that seems to be spot on. Now, still in the exact same position, I switched over to a 9.5 millimeter drill and I added a depth stop here so I won't drill into my table here. And I'm ready to drill through this block, I think. So I keep having to pull down on this handle to apply pressure here. In the meantime, I've got these springs to counterbalance the weight of my spindle and everything. So I figure if I just release the tension on the springs, then that'll give me some downforce and I won't have to push so hard. It's just not drilling at all right now. I just realized why sometimes it doesn't cut. If I back out the drill just briefly, a chip can get caught in front of the point of the drill, and then the chip spins with the drill, so the drill doesn't cut the chip, and the chip doesn't cut the hole, and the whole thing acts as a thrust bearing, preventing me from pushing the rest of the drill into the metal. After finishing the second hole, the workpiece got too hot to touch, so I've been cooling it with a fan before I go on. What such? The hole spacing is not as consistent as I would like it to be, especially this last hole here. But let's just try it to see how it does. Well, that misalignment still seems to be within reason. I can close this joint just fine because these dowels are in here rather loose. And I have a slight bit of misalignment across the surface here. But I think some of that is these holes actually ended up being a fair bit bigger than the drill, so I have a fair bit of wiggle room. And I suspect these holes being a bit larger might be that I ground that point just a little bit off center so that as the drill drills, it kind of goes wobbling a bit and cuts that hole a little bit too large. I cut myself another blank, and this time I timed how long it took with the angle grinder, almost 5 minutes. And I lost 3 millimeters of diameter off of the blade, and I buffed the end a little bit. And you can see it is really quite mirror-like. Got the workpiece mounted, and in this direction I've already got it dialed in. And this time I'm actually using a proper center drill. I bought that many, many years ago at a yard sale. Hopefully that will allow me to place the holes more accurately. And now to avoid having to push down so hard, I'm going to pre-drill with a 5 millimeter drill, although that's risky because that means a bigger drill might grab. And the deeper I'm drilling, the more it sounds kind of crunchy down there. And I think that's just the problem of the chips not clearing adequately and kind of grinding between the drill and the hole. So with the piled holes drilled, I'm now ready with a bigger drill, and this one is actually 0.5 millimeter smaller than my target hole size because last time the hole just got too big. Well, on the plus side, it's drilling much faster, but I'm not sure why it's chattering so much. Well, checking it over, the hole spacing is more consistent than the last time. Lateral position is okay. It does seem to decrease as I go this way. But I can always add a little bit of shim on one side to make up for that. What is also more accurate is the hole size. So this is the drill I drilled it with, and it fits in there quite snug. Not like last time, where the hole is actually quite a bit bigger than the drill, but this is a bit of a problem because I was actually counting on my hole to be bigger than the drill. Now, to bring those holes up to size, I could use a 3/8 inch drill, but that will leave a rough surface, plus it's very likely to grab on the edges of the hole. So I have a 3/8 inch reamer that I just ordered. This is also kind of iffy though, because I need to take off 4% of the reamer size, which is more than they're meant to take.
Oh, beautiful.
That's a really nice, smooth looking hole now. I realized I should probably put something under there so that chips can fall at the bottom. And my 3/8 inch drill fits in there properly snug and smooth. This is becoming like a properly machined part. And adding a slight chamfer around those holes with a larger drill bit. I'm scribing a few alignment lines that show me where the centers of the dowels are, plus the edges of the outermost dowels. The scribing tool I made for this is just a piece of HSS tool blank, which I hammered into a barrel nut, and I turned this part down so it fits inside the collet here.
And finally drilling some countersink holes for the mounting screws.
So it turns out my joint has got a slight bit of twist to that, and so I fixed the jig, and now it doesn't have that. Because somehow the holes on this end of the jig ended up closer to this face than on this side, and I fixed that by just grinding away a bit more on this side to bring it back into level, using a belt grinder built back in 2018. And a smaller mistake that's not possible to hide is I scribed this line in the wrong place. These are my dowel alignment lines, and so I rescribed in the right place, but I can't erase the old one.
So this was my first project on this milling machine-like contraption, which is no substitute for a real milling machine, but it allows me to do things that I couldn't do with the drill press.